One dead for
getting down at the outside. Carrillo's with nades. First nade going out. He can't connect with anything. As he gets, see, he gets pushed off the side of the screen. Throws a grenade at a down kill. Let's see if he's going to be able to pick it up. And he takes out Lava, but he is full red in the middle. Ceiling taking out Yogurt, leaving it in a 2v2 situation. But the lone member of Synergy that is down at the boom shot finally is going down. Let's see if they're going to be able to pick up the kill. And yes, they do, leaving Explosive in a 1v2 situation. But Fallout, if anybody's going to be able to clutch it,
Enta actually got the first down. Right here, Enta. As Enta gets the clutch. Oh, right there. I was just hoping I wouldn't eat my words right there. As Enta going huge, getting a 1v2, keeping his team in it. And this could be the momentum shift you were talking about earlier. Two straight rounds after being down 3-0.
Yep.
And this round is the round that I think will make or break Lava.
As Lava gets the quick pickup on Boom, and he's going to get out safe thanks to Strangulate. But Explosive gets first blood on Kirill's. But I'm going to hop on over to Bobby with the grenades to see if he's going to do it. First aid going out on the top of the steps. Getting a double kill from Bobby Rice, but Strangulate and Lava pick up two kills of their own, leaving Poseidon in a 1v2 situation. And I do believe
I think that was a headshot.
So close.
A smart play by that neck, backing off, getting her health back, and pushing right back up to that flat side.
Yep.
Here we go. Energetic is actually in a great spot. He's going to be able to put shots on both members of the Love Octagon if they just move a little bit.
That was cute right there. He actually L-triggered around the cover so that you couldn't see his ankle right there. Smart play. Here we go.
Able to get out alive and gets the chug on energetics. Lennox pushing up onto Trips, getting a full red, and Enta with the cross at the Love Octagon. Pull it out.
There we go.
As Lava's going to pick up a kill on Ceylon.
Yeah, Lava beat Ceylon into that front door by a mile. As the fight going down, Lava picks up a second kill. Kirill's outside fighting two members. He finally goes down, leaving Bobby in a 1v4, and before I even finished the sentence, it was just all over.
Yeah, Lemon pushing 30 seconds on the hill. Lennox throwing the smoke, able to get there with minimal damage, actually. I thought she was going down across the bridge. Another kill coming out from the Lemon. And to get into the kill, Lennox getting flanked.
Oh,
a
my
huge
God!
Kill by Lennox. Wall for red, leaving the last two members of Greatest.
She don't care.
But they're fighting for 18 seconds right here. Lemon members might be punished for getting these kills, actually, because Greatness is
moving from one spot to another. But Greatness kind of just taking their time right now, sitting still, and not trying to give any opportunities.
They're waiting for the frags, which should be up within like the next 15 or so seconds. Let me try and hop on over. Let's see somebody near the frag grenades. We're going to stay on board Contribs until those nades pop up. And if these veteran players time and weapons like I know I do, they should know the nades should be coming up soon.
Yeah. So nades are definitely going to be coming up soon. There they are. Contribs is right there. Incense coming in. Trying to bait it. Nice bait. Taking a bait Blaze to throw the incense. Blaze obviously trying to capitalize on him going for the grenades. Not going to be able to fully stop them, just cover them up for a little bit. So it lets the timer tick down a little bit more, which might help them if they're going for a stalemate. But regardless, looks like Katrivs is going for it right now, trying to bait out another incend. Let's see how Blaze plays this.
Yeah, I want to hop on over to Blaze, but Blaze is actually working the nades. I don't really know what happened as I was switching screens, but Enta and Blaze in a 1v2 situation. I think they are better off than Greatness was just a little bit, just because they do have an incend.
Yeah, that helps a lot.
Yeah.
And you know, standardly, like, people are going to hold down these pillars, so having an incend to possibly grab a kill is super important.
As you see Blaze, you see him slightly moving his camera. I think he's just trying to set something up. A failed nade coming out from Greatness.
Yeah, it looked like maybe they thought somebody was over there, but nothing.
Oh, there it is!
Instant from Blaze.
Kobe!
You can see a mirroring round, just like I said, a 3v2 turning into a 2v2, and a member of Greatness is full red.
That's exactly what they needed right there.
Boy, Enta. Enta, you need to
put here
he
goes.
As I said, he dies to the instant. Huge play by Enta and Blaze in a 3v2. They actually looks like they're going to try and clutch it out. Energetics in a 1v2 situation. Full red.
Oh!
Blaze pulling it out, a 3v2.
Hello, my name is Jacob, also known as PR. I'm coming at you with this casting reel just to let you guys know that I am the guy for the job. I am very passionate about it, and not only that, I've been around for a while. I know the community. I know the players, majority of them on a personal level, over years and years of time already. I know the game. I think I can bring a great analysis / play-by-play for what's going on. Able to relate to the players, give an inside view. I can also, you know, hype up any storylines that are going down within the series today, or not today, but within the Pro League. I really want this, I guess. That's what I'm really trying to say, and I'm willing to work for it. I'm willing to do everything I can to get this spot, and as you can see in the video before, I have casted multiple Hypefist Station LAN events, multiple Hypefist Station online events, and multiple other miscellaneous events from Gearshead Central to Matters Gaming to even back in the Crudy days with Revolution Gaming. I've just always been there, I've been around, and I know what I'm talking about for the most part when it comes to these things, whether it be the matches, the players, the thought processes. I know multiple players' tendencies, whether they're going to draw around, push around, the type of stuff they want to do. I know this like the back of my hand, and it all started, you know, I'm going to give shout-outs to Blaze. He brought me into the beginning of Gears 3, gave me that shot, and I hope, you know, I hadn't let it down since. I don't think I have. The majority of the community enjoys my commentary, whether it be because I'm a goofball or because I actually know what I'm talking about compared to some of the other casters we've seen around come and go. And I just want to be a part of the team. I want to be a part of the casting team. I want to do this for the Gears of War community. I want to do this for the Gears of War franchise. And I want to do this for ESL and the Coalition. I just need that one shot. And that's why I'm making this video today, to show you that I am going to work for it. And hopefully you guys give me that opportunity to bring some light, bring a show, bring some entertainment to this Gears of War community when it comes to casting. And with that said, I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and have a great night.